Good day, everyone. For this video, we'll be discussing about the boiler water, the feed water, and engine cooling waters, which are used in our operations in the marine operation. So to start with, we'll be discussing about boiler. So the main purpose of our boiler is to convert water, liquid water, into a steam, which is a gaseous form of water under regulated circumstances. Boilers are an essential source of energy in the process industries because they provide steam to run process equipment and create the steam required throughout the plant. This is according to NAPTA 2018. So there are types of boilers. We have the water tube boilers and the fire tube boilers. So for the water tube boilers, they get their name from the fact that they have water-filled tubes that allow water to circulate throughout a hot fire box. So from the word itself, water tube, meaning there is water inside the tube. Upper and lower drums are linked by tubes in the water tube boilers. The upper drum is known as your steam drum, and the bottom drum is known as your mud drum. So remember this always. Your upper drum is your steam drum because this is where your steam will come out, or basically in the upper part of your boiler. And the bottom drum are usually the solids or the sludge, so thus the name mud drum. Fire tube boilers, on the other hand, heat water on the boiler's shell side by transferring hot combustion gases via the tubes. So in this case, when we talk about fire tube boiler, what is inside the tube are your heat source, like your exhaust gas and at the same time your fuels and hot gases. So the combustion gases are routed via the tubes while the water is sent through the shell in this sort of boiler. The water tube within the shell must be maintained in this sort of device. The tubes must be constantly covered or it may overheat or cause damage. So this is your fire tube boiler. So to illustrate, and once again for your familiarization, talk about water tube. Again, what's inside the tube is the water, the liquid water that is being converted into steam. And outside the tube is the furnace containing your hot gases. On the other hand, talk about fire tube boiler, what is inside the tube are your exhaust gases or your hot combustion gases. And inside the shell are your water, which is being converted into steam. So the basic boiler operation principle, a heat source, a water drum, a water intake, and a steam output comprise a simple boiler. The water drum in this type of boiler is partially filled with water before heat is introduced. When water is sufficiently heated, steam develops. So this is the process of vaporization. As the steam exits the vessel, it is caught and transported to other stages of the process, for example, to spin a steam turbine or to a heat exchanger. To compensate for the liquid loss as steam, we basically input makeup water now inside our boiler. So we talk about makeup water. This is the water that is added to make up for losses, particularly evaporation-related losses, because we need to monitor the level of water inside our boiler, not too high or not too low. So therefore, if there is evaporation inside our boiler, then therefore there will be loss of water inside the boiler, and we need to compensate with that particular loss, and we need to introduce our makeup water. Makeup water is used to replace the pure water that is evaporating from the tower. Since some water evaporates during each passage through the system, makeup water is required so that our boiler will not dry up and in the long run, overheat. So this is our simple boiler diagram. As you may see, you have here your fuel, your water in, wherein you have liquid water converted to steam. And this particular steam will be the one to drive our turbine to produce energy and electricity inside our marine vessel. So we need also to consider about boilers, the heat transfer that is involved in this particular machine. So heat transfer within a steam boiler takes place in three different ways. We have the radiation, convection, and the conduction. The rate of heat transfer is driven by the temperature difference between the fire, the flame, the flue gas, and the water. Take note, temperature difference. The higher the temperature difference, the higher will be the energy transfer or heat transfer. Since the water temperature is normally fixed by the steam pressure, the only way of maximizing the temperature difference is to maximize the temperature of the fire or the flame. So this is a basic illustration of the different heat transfer as applied to boilers. So we have the conduction between the hot and also your stove here, direct contact. So this is conduction. Your water circulates inside your boiler, like your hot water rises and your cold water sinks, and the cycle continues. Thus, this is what you call as your convection. And lastly, radiation is element transfer heat to the kitchen by radiation. In this sense, if you even you are away from the stove or away from the boiler, you can still sense the temperature or the heat as radiated by our boiler. So next, we need also to consider what you call as our steam. Steam is a vapor form when water is heated. So this is a gaseous form of water, and it has a lot of energy. Steam offers heat transfer efficiency and significant quantity of latent heat. It's used to heat and chill things, process fluids, power and purge equipment, put out fires, make distillation easier, and induce additional physical and chemical reaction. That is our steam. This is the product of our boiler. This is why we use boiler in order for us in marine engineering to produce our steam. Now, let's talk about boiler water. Boiler water is liquid water that is designed for evaporation into steam within a boiler or in connected pipework, pumps, and other equipment. So, talk about boiler water, this is the water inside our boiler. The concept of convection governs the circulation of boiler water. When the fluid is heated, it expands and becomes less dense, allowing it to move upward through heavier, denser fluids. So as what I mentioned earlier, we talked about convection, this is where your liquid circulates. Hot water rises, cold water sinks, and the cycle continues inside the boiler. So this is a basic chemical or chemistry diagram for the process of convection. So boiler feed water. Boiler feed water is water that has been purified or preheated before being given to the boilers for the creation of hot water and steam, or it might stay still. It's most often seen in thermal power plants where it's kept and conditioned in tanks called boiler feed water tank. Okay, so talk about boiler feed water. So this is what we insert or we introduce to our boiler to make up for the water losses due to evaporation. And we call it as our boiler feed water. So take note. We need to take note of this particular caution. So feed water caution. The levels and flows of boiler feed water are crucial to the successful operation of the boiler. The tubes will overheat and fail if the feed water flow is lower, meaning the flow is slower as compared to the normal, and that the water level falls to the point where the boiler runs dry. And we don't like it to happen because once your boiler runs dry, there might be a possibility of accident, and not to mention explosion if there is a pressure build up inside your boiler if not monitored properly. Excess water will be carried over into the steam distribution system. If the boiler water level grows too high, this has a severe impact on process facility steam, consumers, and can cause damage to turbines and other equipment. So we also don't like to overflow our water inside our boiler since some of it will join our steam line. And therefore, once it joins our steam, we will have a wet steam, and that will cause corrosion to the process tubes or pipelines where your steam is flowing. So therefore, we don't like carry over in our system because it might hinder the process. And take note, this particular wet steam will hinder the process because it will not efficiently rotate our turbine, so thus lower the energy output of our process. So engine cooling water. So engine cooling water is liquid water used to manage the temperature of internal combustion engine elements in order to prevent overheating and retain all functioning dimensions. So from the word itself, cooling water, the main purpose is to cool our system. So cooling water is circulated through internal tubes to to keep engines cool. So remember, as we use your machineries and also your engine, it is getting hotter or warmer at the same time. So there must be a particular coolant to cool this particular operation, since that might cause damage also to our operation. So fresh water is the most often used coolant. Seawater or salt water is not utilized directly as coolant due to its corrosive impact. So we need to take note that most of the time you use fresh water, but in heat exchangers or what you call as the open system, we also use seawater, but not all the time since it is ha or it has a corrosive impact or operation. The primary engine is cooled by two different but related systems. An open system, so what I mentioned earlier, C2C, that takes water from and returns it to the sea, that is the seawater cooling, and a closed system that circulates the fresh water around engine casing or the fresh water cooling. But take note, most of the time, especially when we're talking about our main engine, our cooling water is a fresh water, a demineralized distilled water. So the last water that we need to understand by definition is your condensate water. This is a product of condensation. So when we talk about condensation, that is the process wherein your gas turns back to liquid. So the process of gas changing into liquid is condensation. And condensate water is a liquid phase that results from the condensation of any gas, including your steam. So talk about condensate water. This is a product of your condenser wherein your process steam, after flowing throughout the system, will now be converted back into liquid. And take note, this condensate water is added to our makeup water to make our feed water as we supply it to our pump. That's it for our video for this afternoon or for this day. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day. Bye-bye.